your most accurate meteorologist using the most advanced radar, live Super Doppler HD, keeping you safe under an umbrella protection.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. A few clouds out there this afternoon. Still quite a bit of moisture left over from last night's rain. So with the bright sun today, popped a lot of cumulus clouds. 77 right now. Dew point 61, 58% northwest winds. And the pressure steady at 29.76. This is the radar from last night. And on the left side of your screen, the rainfall pattern. On the right side of your screen, the wind pattern. This is the wind velocity. And that's what we watched to figure out where these tornadoes really are. So this one, roughly 6 to 7 miles north, and you can see the bright green and the bright pink located right up against each other, what we call gate-to-gate shear. That's what Curtis noticed on the radar last night and pinpointed this tornado within a half mile of its actual location on the ground. If you're only looking at the rain, that's where the tornado would be. But with the wind pattern on the radar, very easy to see at 5:08. If we take a three-dimensional view of the radar, you can see the downdraft coming down here. We have air rising, and this is an actual three-dimensional real-time depiction, and you can almost see where that tornado is extending from the cloud base down to the ground. Now, later on, there was additional tornado warnings, but these cells, not nearly as impressive. 844, you can kind of see a little bit of a hook in the rain pattern near St. Charles, but look over here. And the wind pattern on this is much, much lighter and not coming right up against each other. So there was broad-scale turning, but more of a damaging wind kind of scenario, and they did not confirm any tornado damage in Warren County, more so a straight line or downburst type of winds there. So the radar pretty valuable last night. Upper 60s today to the north as the cooler air was coming in to replace the warm, muggy air of the last couple of days. The 80s getting pushed off to the south and to the east along with the rain. A few thunderstorms far northeast Iowa, Wisconsin. There's some remnant ones on the tail end of the front in Nebraska. We could see an isolated shower in central Iowa later tonight. But for the most part, clear skies tonight, patchy fog developing with the remnant moisture and 58 degrees. And as we move on through the day tomorrow, 79 for a high. It'll be a very nice day, less humid. Winds out of the north at about 5 to 10 miles per hour. And then as we look into Friday, pretty good chance of some early morning and late day thunderstorms. These two could potentially be strong to severe. Saturday, a little bit of lingering precipitation, 82. Sunday right now looks like it will be dry. Monday as well. Temperatures pretty mild in the upper 70s to around 80 degrees.
Okay. That was a wild night last night.
A good reminder to get those weather radios if you don't have them already and make sure they're programmed.